Hello everybody, and welcome back to The Hunter, Call of the Wild, hopefully. Hunter, Call of the Wild? We got to Call of the Wild? We do, fantastic. We have audio on OBS. We do, even more fantastic, amazing. I've been streaming a wee bit of this in the meantime, in the recent weeks and months. I've mostly been streaming on Hirschfeld and Observe and a little bit on Medved. Today we're not going to either of those places because last week I streamed The Hunter, Call of the Wild with a stream entitled He's the King, a reference to the new gun that I was trying out, the King 470DB, and an old director VHS movie called Dougal and the Blue Cat. Yesterday, Queen Elizabeth II died. It's one of those moments that you know logically is going to happen to you, but you don't actually really expect it to. Like, there's no way it can't, but when you think about it, your brain just sort of dismisses it. It's like, nah, that'll never happen. So the UK is a little bit shell-shocked today, and likely will be for the next 2 to 3 weeks, honestly. We've got about 10-ish days, it is expected, until a state funeral, and then there'll be something like another 5 to 7 days of official royal mourning. There's going to be a whole host of things going on as the new King Charles III, which is a phrase that was also logically one I was going to have to say at some point but never thought I would use, really, as he kind of does all of his stuff. Gets to know the cabinet of the UK. He has a sort of official swearing-in ceremony kind of thing tomorrow. They'll be planning for an actual proper coronation at some point, although that won't necessarily be soon. He'll have his first meetings with various different subdivisions of government and probably a whole host of other people. It's going to be a bit of a crazy time here in the UK. Also, everything actually politically relevant, like, you know, the cost of living crisis, the fact that there's, like, a war on in Europe, all of that is going to be completely swept aside, brushed under the rug. Nothing is going to be done about it at all. The only policies that are going to happen in the next 10 days are going to be policies the government doesn't want anyone to know about because they're actually really evil, and they think they can hide them underneath Queen's death-related headlines. So, country's in a bit of a mess, but I thought I didn't know what to do today, because I thought it was worth acknowledging that it had happened, but I didn't know how to do anything with that with streaming. And then I realised, well, okay, you know, I don't have any games in my library that are obviously Queen or Britain related that aren't about the deaths or usurpations of said queens, and also whatever Assassin's Creed, whatever the English Assassin's Creed is. I've got that kicking around there somewhere. But I thought what I do have is Call of the Wild, which I've been playing a lot. And Call of the Wild does not, of course, just have the maps that I've been playing. It has Vahonga Savannah, which is set in somewhere nebulously in sort of Southeast Africa, almost all of which is Commonwealth territory. And it has Te Awaroa in New Zealand. And it does also have Yukon Valley, which is sort of nebulously in either Alaska or Canada or maybe both. But I thought, well, we can drop into some of these other things. Some of these new reserves, we'll hopefully have a chance to... Actually, should have done this. Give me a second. I realized that there was a thing I needed to do before I did do this, and that requires me to actually load into a different reserve, which has unfortunately upset my game quite a lot. Come on, Hunter. There we go. Yeah, so what I thought was, we'll head to Verhunga first, partly because I've got the king already set up for it. And I want to drop in and fix my kit. Maybe also change the time so it's daytime so we can actually see these new reserves that we've got going on. How loud is that? That's probably a goodish level of volume for you. Might tweak it down just a bit for when we do ballers. Right, okay. Fix kit. So I want to grab a gun that I've another gun that I've never used before. Which is the .303 British. I guess. Ooh, this is locked. I wonder why that's locked. I want it in burnished. I should check that I don't already have one. I don't already have one. Okay, marvelous. Oh, it does actually tick it off if you've got one. So the .303, I don't exactly know what this rifle is, but the 303 is kind of like a traditional British Army gun caliber. The famous .303, it was the Lee Enfield, which was World War One or interwar year era rifle. I can't remember which. I think they ended up giving quite a few of them to the Home Guard as well, but don't quote me on that. We've got the soft points and the poly tips. We want the poly tips. We want, let's say, 40 of these. Right. I'll take off the coachmate. We'll keep the shotgun for now. Actually, we'll check if I can get more stuff for the other shotgun. On the 4.303. Take off the 40-70 shots. Grab the 0.303 British. So these are actually kind of a really good complement to the King DB that I hadn't noticed before, because they cover ranges. They cover classes 4 to 8. So we're going to Vahonga, where there's two big class 9s. There's the Cape Buffalo and the Lion, and then there's quite a range underneath that that this will sort of nicely pick up on. Who do we have? We have a first-time chat from Dutchie the Kiwi saying "Slug go bloom." Hi there, Dutchie. How are you doing? Slug go boom. Slug definitely can go boom. Did we get any slug shots off last stream? I can't remember. Yes, I do have the king. I really, really enjoyed playing around with that gun last time. I was expecting to kind of not really like it because it doesn't have a proper scope and stuff, but I really enjoyed it. Shotguns. So I've got this. I can now get the birdshot for this. And I probably don't technically need the slugs. Shall we get the 12 gauge out then? That is so neat. Just make sure I've got loads of it. Francis, oh, did I actually buy? Do I actually own one? Yes, I am the Caversham steward. Do I have the sheriff shotgun? I don't know, partly because I don't know which one the sheriff shotgun is. You can see the list of shotguns that I have here. If one of these is the sheriff shotgun, then yes, is DLC. It depends which DLC pack it's in. I have quite a sort of an eclectic selection of the weapon shotgun weapon packs. Right, we'll take off the 20 gauge, put on the 12 gauge, HMTQ 12 gig. Oh, it's too heavy. It's too heavy. That's because I haven't taken this off. Now it's fine. There we go. Marvelous. We'll also, I suppose, need a whole bunch of different callers. What animals are in the Honga Savannah? Let me check. Buffalo, lion, gemsbok, wildebeest, warthog we'll need the pig caller for. So we'll need this. Don't need that. We don't need that. This apparently calls lions. Okay, I was expecting the bigger caller to call lions, but okay. Caribou, lesser kudu, and gemsbok. I think at least one of those was on that list. Gemsbok is. Lesser kudu is. Okay, we still need something for the scrub hair. Oh, we're not going to get a scrub hair caller, are we? We need something for the sidestruck jackal, the springbok, the wildebeest, and the buffalo. If such things exist. This can also attract springbok. This also attracts lions. So this attracts both the sidestruck jackal and the lion. So I'd rather have this, even though it's a horrible noise. This for turkeys, this for turkeys. Let's have a quick look. In here, callers. Beacon Deluxe duck call, I don't care about ducks. Don't care about those. That's everything, okay. It's in the smoking barrels. No, I definitely don't have the smoking barrels pack. Right. Is that everything? I think that's everything. Let's go into our inventory. Inventory. Set up to hotkeys. King's still on 5. 303 is going on 1. Shotgun's going on 3. Oh, I did not check what blimmin'. Rifle scope you want, did I? I haven't checked what scopes you need either, actually. Shotguns. Casual steward. Red Raptor reflex sight. Or a shotgun scope, which I don't have enough score for. I don't think I like this sight, do I? Feel like. Right, I don't need that. I need something that my 303 is compatible with. What are you compatible with? Argus 8-16. Or the Hyperion 4-8x42. I think I want this, the Argus 8-16x. That's the highest magnification we've got. So, okay. Let's grab an Argus. There we go. Up. Argus on me. Oh, excuse me. Argus on me. Thank you. Red Raptor reflex sight on you. Ammo, poly tips. Let's keep buckshot in for now as our sort of default. Callers. Got the antler rattler. Keeping that. Buck snort wheeze thing. Go there. That's all the calls we really need. Fantastic. So let's have a look at what this scope looks like. It's okay, it's gonna be okay to use. This. Less of a fan than what I've got on the King and what I have on the other shotgun. I don't know why I like this more. I should like it less. But I don't. And with that. How do I get to a new reserve? What's the quickest way to get to a new reserve? Exit to my menu. There we go. The Miller Model 1891 uses 10 gauge slugs, which are, to put simply, boom. So, are you a person, Dutchy, who knows things about guns and how they work? Because this is going to make me seem tragically underinformed, but I don't understand why a 12 gauge shotgun is better than a 20 gauge shotgun, or why the higher number for a 20 gauge does not correlate to a. Oh, hello.
Welcome home. I know it looks different than you remember. We've had some problems here at Voronga Savannah. I've watched the sun rise and set over this park for 45 years. I've seen miracles of life, wonders of nature you would not believe. Our family's roots here run deeper than the oldest baobab tree in the park. But after 45 years, I'm humble enough to admit I can't be senior warden forever. Droughts, disease, and poachers are a constant threat. My team and I have protected and saved countless species over the years. But after a streak of bad luck, our elephants and all but one rhino are gone. If we lose more animals, the state could shut us down. See? I'm not about to hand the keys to my office to just anyone. I want to keep the role of senior warden in my tribe. Preferably my family. So, grandchild, here you are, standing in the bush. You can protect Voronga. Save the animals who call this park home. Mend what has been broken. This will make our ancestors proud. Spiritually, physically, you're going to face the most difficult challenges of your life, but you can overcome them. I believe in your talent. I always have. Now, ready to prove Grandfather Njabulo right?
Okay, so first off, he's our canonical grandfather? That's kind of cool.
You must have had a long flight, didn't you?
Okay.
Well, let's stretch your legs with some basics. You can finish these in any order you like.
I can't, because I'm lost in the grass.
With this area. Climb the nearest lookout tower. Take in the view, take note of your landmarks, and see if you can spot any wildlife. Then I'd go ahead and reopen the nearest outpost. We stopped keeping them up after last year's budget cuts. With your help, they'll make fine shelters again.
Fantastic.
Finally, show me your hunting skills. Track and harvest an animal of your choosing. I'll be judging the quality of your kill.
Okay, have you finished speaking? Can I speak now? Okay, marvelous. So, first off, as you can see, straight away, I saw a need zone, wanted to grab it. Second off, he wants us to be senior warden. When I was honestly struggling to even get out of... what? That says chasing. Hello? Is it chasing me? That would be a really bad start. Yeah, secondly, I was not even competent enough to get out of the grass. So, that doesn't bode super duper well. Hello, lion? Wait, I should be tracking you. You shouldn't be tracking me. I'm the hunter. I have a gun. this place is blooming beautiful, isn't it? That's worth noting. Before I am mauled to death. Okay. Oh, I've got a lion caller. Why don't I use this? I mean, because it sounds horrible is why I shouldn't use that, but still. Are we going to go straight in and see if we can track a lion? Okay, I've got to harvest an animal as one of my quests. And he said he'd be judging the quality of my kill. They can't climb trees, can they? No, it's leopards. What time is it? 6:03 a.m. It's good that it said it's 6:03 a.m. because I was going to sleep before I made the trip over here, and I forgot. And now I'm lightly glad that I forgot, because it would have been wasted money. Okay. Miley boy. Does this really attract a lion? This thing that's for attracting, like, tiny little predators. That's a blue wildebeest. I don't have a wildebeest collar, do I? It's a shame. It's okay.
Hamganyi, the blue wildebeest, were born to run. And they can run in herds of thousands. Unfortunately, they are not the healthiest animals. Diseases like foot and mouth spread quickly among them. So do parasites. We must keep a watchful eye over our fleet-footed friends.
So that's the justification for hunting them in-game. Herds of thousands, though, that's quite exciting. I suspect the game can't render herds of thousands. Oh my gosh. Wow. You can see for quite a ways out here. I don't need that on. Holy wow. Where the hell was that wildebeest? If it comes to it, where the hell was that lion? Maybe the lion was chasing the wildebeest? That would explain why neither of them is here. Canter. I've never seen a track at a canter before. I've only seen trots, runs, and walks. What the hell is a canter? What are you? Not seeing you. Hit him. I don't think I hit him well. No, no organs hit. Well, that was a disappointing first shot. Honestly. Oh, I want the map. Where am I? I'm in the central savannah in more or less the middle of the map. I'm kind of surprised that didn't hit any organs, actually. I sort of thought that was right on target for a right lung. I hear someone. Someone's here. That wildebeest hasn't died, has it? But he's kind of going in roughly the direction I want to be going in. I'm actually very surprised, because normally the reserves give you like a little frozen animal to shoot. I didn't see one. Maybe I didn't go far enough. Maybe that wouldn't impress Grandpappy very much. Well, as first shots go, I'm not very happy. As first animals go, probably better this than the lion. That's another lion noise. very nervous about the lions. Are you sure you attract lions? Are you, like, really sure? Shouldn't leave that other beast with a bullet in it, but it's also gonna run for ages and ages and ages and ages at all. So I kind of can't do it. I see neither lion nor evidence of lion. Let's just head to the tower. Let's just head to the tower. If we're lucky, we'll happen to espy something to shoot on the way. I do want to get a fast travel point. Maybe I should grab the other caller. Distressed fawn caller. Maybe that's more likely to target lions, because I think I do have the perk that's like callers have a low chance to attract certain off-target species. So maybe the lion is the off-target species for this caller, and they don't always respond to it. Actually, based on that logic, I might want to grab some of the other cores that can also, so I have overlap. That's a speed sign. I got very excited there for a second. We've gone a grand total of exactly nowhere so far in this game, which is fine. We have 3 hours. Although given I wanted to change at some point, we've actually got like an hour and a half, of which I've already used half an hour. But this feels more populous than the early game areas of the other reserves I've tried so far. Because early game Leighton and early game Hirschfelden both felt particularly barren. I just realized my stream quality is terrible because OBS is being a pain. Let's close that down and see if it runs a little better. Words. I was saying them, kind of what they were. Oh yeah, no. Medved was better, but I think because I started playing Medved in the dark, that was less conducive to me finding a bunch of animals. Again. Where are you, lion boy? Oh, he didn't respond. He did another respond. Hello? Lion. Should I be inviting a lion to come to me? Maybe not. But it's too late now. I didn't think of that beforehand. I was just like, oh yeah, let's just hoot the hooter. And everything will be fine. I've got to go through this tall grass again. This grass is going to very quickly become the bane of my existence in this reserve, isn't it? Although it is at least not loud. Unlike the rushes and reeds of Leighton. Mayan? No lion. Lion free. Warning, pigs crossing. Actually, if this pig crossing area begins at this sign that says pigs crossing, and ends at this sign which says pigs crossing for the other way, the pigs presumably are very orderly in the place they cross. Lion? No lion, okay. That's so pretty. Can I take a picture? If I take that picture, will it have the tokens on screen? No, it won't. I might use that as my, transition image when I come back to the hunger. Because that's very nice looking. Or I might take a better one from the top of this. That's another possibility. Okay. Well, we're gonna run when we get to the top of this anyway. So we might as well run. Definitely no lion. Oops, can I get the stairs, please? This is a lot of floors. Lookout point. Survey. Holy yikes.
You see it again, don't you? Africa. The land where people began. I knew you couldn't leave Voronga forever, grandchild. The day our family adopted you, I saw the fire.
Adopted.
That child is Noi. Mystical. Magical. And now I know I'm right. The ancestors brought you back here on my behalf. Thank you for coming. You've still got those other jobs to do, right? Don't slack!
Understood. Oh, okay, I see. I mean, us being adopted does make sense how he can be our grandfather despite us being able to choose from a range of ethnicities, etc. It's also nice that he says grandchild. I mean, sufficiently he says grandchild rather than having a separate dialogue option for male and female choices. But I actively like that it's kept gender neutral. I actually didn't look out for any animals at all from the top of that, did I? It's fine. That looks epic. Are those single rocks? That's enormous, if so. Oh my gosh, are those animals sleeping? I can't tell. They might not be. They might just be like stones on the ground. Given that there's a big old rock there. No, I think they are just stones, sadly. Oh yeah, because look, there's loads of them over here as well. This is just a place what has lots of stones in it. I actually have no idea of the geology of how these rocks and stuff came to be here. If we were in Europe, I'd say, oh, those are clearly glacial erratics. But I don't know if where we are, it makes sense for them to be glacial erratics. I mean, we're not in post-glacial valleys. That's for certain. So I'm assuming they're not glacial erratics. But we don't seem, to my mind, to be deserty enough for these to be Aeolian landforms either. So I actually don't know what's going on here. Oh, hello, what's this? Wildebeest, mating call. Okay. Maybe we'll have a little more success on this one. I definitely don't have a call for these guys, do I? Oh, I do! The Bucksnort caller. Oh, I just got an achievement called Call of the Wild, presumably for using a certain number of different callers. That was a particularly horrible noise. We cross this bit. The wildebeest does not seem to be here. Is this also called Cape Buffalo? No. It does also call Lesser Cooper. Is that supposed to be an animal? Wildebeest. Wildebeest. Where are you? How can Africa have such good sight lines and yet have nothing in those sidelines? Lawnmower. I don't, because lawnmowers are ecologically devastating things, but is this the same wildebeest that I was tracking before? These are blue tracks. Are you anywhere to be seen? At all? No, but somebody else is. That's a springbok. Class 3. Class 3 is a little bit of a problem because I have to get close to them. Because... Hello. You spot that? Did you hear that? Yes, they heard that and ran away. But I got the. Oh, you didn't run away. Okay. Right. I'll grab this and then see if I can sneak up on them. There we go. Oh, he's a gold one as well.
Ask more of you. That was perfectly executed.
It actually was, kind of.
Now you just have to do one more thing. Then I have a surprise for you. No, I'll spoil the surprise for you. It's more work.
I'm very happy with that as a first kill in this place. Like, the first shot was perfectly on target, but it just had no penetration. Because it got lodged in the neck. The problem is we're shooting something front on. This, however, fantastic shot, love it. Exactly where I wanted it to go. Might have liked to avoid the bone, but didn't hurt. Anyway, where did those... where were those springboks? Hold on a sec. Springboks, where were you? There. There you are. Gotcha. Okay, they are 200 meters away. Well, they're very bouncy. You can see why they're called springboks, I guess. Make sure I've got the right ammo in my shotgun. Buckshot. Class 2 to 5. These are class 3. I want to get a little closer and then figure out what caller I have for these guys. Bucksnort again. This is a weird place where, like, my callers seem to do lots of different species. Okay. You guys move. Did you leave? Or is that you? I don't think you left. This could be a problem. Is this entirely open ground between me and you? More or less. I think they're over a ridge. If they are over a ridge, that's kind of fine. Yeah, there's lots of areas with not much cover. I'm noticing, so maybe the shotgun wasn't the best choice. I mean, for like when you've got to cover classes 1, 2, and 3, there aren't lots of good choices. I'm gonna hide in this bush. I'm gonna call. See if they come. So I'd much rather they come to me while I'm hidden. Perfect. I need you a bit closer than that, actually. You've gone away. I need you about 25 meters away, ideally. That's the opposite of what I just said. Come on. Come back. Come back. Maybe I should... no, I shouldn't do that. Just hold. Okay, they're not coming. Hide in this bush. Sneaky, sneaky hunter. I feel like humans are quite good at actually getting low for mammals of our size. Because we are quite flat-chested. Other animals have kind of got a lot of trunk going on, if you will. How close are you? Perfect. Can't zoom in, of course I can't. I don't know how I want to shoot you. I think I want to be side on, which is going to be a problem. Got him. This is a very ugly looking gun. Is it? Oh, it's got the two barrels over one another instead of one on top, one underneath. Oh, that's weird. Okay, well, we got him. We did penetrate. Oh, we got him in the neck. That's why he went down so fast. We did also touch his head, but not enough to mess up the trophy. Okay. Well, that's not bad for a second shot. Shall we head off to the little house? Okay, well, so far we've seen a wildebeest and three springbok. We eventually harvested the wildebeest, and we harvested one of the three springbok. And I'm kind of okay with that. Maybe I should have picked up a. See, the problem with the bow and arrow is, like, the shotgun isn't super duper great for class 3 and 4. Although, actually, this one might be because it's bigger. The other shotgun we had was not that good for class 3 and 4. It sort of didn't really have enough penetrating power to actually hit any vital organs. So, like, they die, but we wouldn't get a full hunting check, harvest check. But a bow and arrow, although there are arrows you can get, which will hit the class ones, even with like my rangefinder bow, I'm not confident in my ability to hit a class one with it at a close enough range that I can actually sort of get to. I don't know how skittish the rabbits are in this. Rabbits in Leighton, you could get just about close enough to bow hunt. Just about. And that was me with my low tech Hawaii, I can't pronounce that, recurve bow. I could definitely take a shot from further away with the rangefinder bow. But the ducks in Leighton and the geese of Hirschfelden, you've got no chance of sneaking to within shooting range on one of those. The ducks, particularly, they don't normally even land within shooting range. Now for geese, or okay, if you want a dedicated hunt ducks and geese, then I suppose yes, you could probably bring them into to within bow range using decoys and callers. But if you just sort of want to be like I am and be kind of quite an opportunistic hunter, just sort of taking whatever is nearby, you can't reasonably take a class one with a bow most of the time, which is why I've got the shotguns. Maybe the 20 gauge will solve all of my problems. Maybe the 20 gauge, no, maybe the 12 gauge will have enough stopping power to take down the medium-sized deer. Oops, I'm stuck on that tree. In fact, actually, is this shotgun just a straight upgrade then? On the 12 gauge? If you know anything about me at all, you know I'm not a super duper fan of when equipment is just like a straight upgrade on another bit of equipment. I much prefer, like, when there's valid reasons to chop and change your loadout. Yeah, take the 303 British that I've got at the moment. It's useful here, but it's not particularly more useful than the coachmate that I had on Hirschfelden for Hirschfelden. Because Hirschfelden, I believe, doesn't have a Class 8. And you know, if I was using a different gun to hit Class 9s, like one of the ones that hits Classes 6 to 9, then the four, just having the British for a four, Class 4 and Class 5 is less attractive of an option. So I like that there's trade-offs between them, but if the shotgun is just a straight upgrade, that's less trade-offy. Right, we're nearly home. I say home. I'm not sure if the outposts are really home, but I just realised I'm gonna run a flag up this flagpole, but there's an option to have it at half mast, which is how flags, how I should be flying flags at the moment. Tisk tisk. Oh wow, we are right up close to whatever this crazy thing is. We've got to go check it out. I mean, that must be an information point that will tell us why are there these big old rocks here. So let's go find out what's up with the big old rocks.
That is everything I ask you to do. Away, grandchild.
Away? I don't actually know what away means.
Oh no, we have a problem. Remember how we lost the elephants and all but one rhino? You know what the
Mentioned.
problem was, don't you? Poachers.
Always is.
They littered the reserve with traps. The Vusha, the eastern land, was hit hardest. My crew helped the police push these poachers out of the Vusha, but they left so many traps behind, no matter how many we've cleared, we keep finding more. A junior guide spotted a few of these traps not far from where you started. Could you kindly clear them out?
Probably. Oh, I've never tried clearing traps in this game before. That'll be interesting. I want to grab Right, was a caller I already owned? So I've got the carry weight for another caller. Let's grab this as the additional line caller. That it? Is that the only other caller that I can take? Okay, apparently that's everything. Nine, I guess. Sure. Yeah, I'll go do the trap thing in a bit, maybe. But I kind of mostly want to just be hunting today. I don't really want to be doing the story. Like, I wanted to make sure I had a outpost set up. And now I want to go look at what the hell this thing is, and then go find some more things to shoot. I've just seen the news on Twitter. The Premier League has called off all football matches this weekend. That's how you know Britain really is in a mess, when we don't even care about football anymore. Personally, I don't give a damn about whether the football's on or not. But, I like the news. It comes from Robert Paston, who is ITV's chief political editor, I believe. It says, the Cabinet Office made clear this morning such cancellations of sporting or other events were not obligatory. How would they make it obligatory? You know, like, pass a law that says, nope, you can't have anything on. Say pass a law saying, I can't stream today because the Queen is dead. I was talking about equipment that was a straight upgrade. That's one of the things I like the least about the Angler, even though I'm sure it is true to life. One of the things I don't like about it is that when you get a better rod or a better line or whatever, it is just better. Like, there's no, to my knowledge, way that a strength 10 kilo line is not better than a strength 1 kilo line, apart from the worse rods can't equip the 10 kilo line. But then the rod that can equip the 10 kilo line is also a straight upgrade from the line that can only equip the 1 kilo line. The Honker Heights. The Dutch call these rocky outcrops kopjes, which I'm not pronouncing correctly, which means little head. They may seem like warts on the landscape at first glance. No, they don't. They seem beautiful. They provide a range of benefits. They collect water, provide shade to plants. Some animals have even evolved limbs adapted to traversing the rugged terrain. Guests love to climb them. And more than once, I've discovered people on them. Wow. I mean, to be fair, that's exactly what I would do, but I don't know what that's about, because a rocky hill shade, as may be, is not exactly a comfortable place to lie on. No, I'm sure it's not. Inverted commas entirely my own there. Where do we want to head? Where do we want to go? There's a lake down that way. There's a lake down this way, actually. Let's head here. Call it a watering hole. Might be a place for animals to gather. My latent instinct kicking in is, you want animals, go where there's water. I love the heat haze effects as well. Actually, I wonder if there's anything, I wonder if we can like climb this at all. Find some people having relations. We'll find a mask, a collectible. I sort of guess there might be a collectible here. Codex. The Hunger Artifact. Mask of Sangoma. Oh, that's cool. Shame there's no info about it. I really like that about this game, so they litter in collectibles and lore in a game that it like doesn't strictly need them. But, like, it's so much better for having them. You know. I can see if we're quite far from here. 440 meters is about... 450 is about the render distance. I think. Hello. Springbok over there. Having lunch. There's a springbok over there having lunch. Let's go for the first one, shall we? I was worried initially that like this would be full of big wide open spaces with no one in them. Because Hirschfelden has quite a lot of intermediate size open spaces with no one in them. Leighton has, like, not super duper wide open spaces, but they often have people in them. Or I say people, animals in them. I'm glad that you can sort of get up on a big old lookout point, cast your gaze out a few hundred meters, and actually see stuff. I'm not gonna lie, I'm still kind of hoping to see a lion, even though it will probably shred me. And again, in case it needs to be said, IRL, definitely don't hunt lions. That's like a real bad person thing to do. Oh, a couple tracks over here. We might pick them up as we head off towards our springboard friends. Oh my gosh, excuse me. I need to meet myself. That's my phone going off. WhatsApp group call. Or group I'm in. Bing. It's ye. Hey there. What's up, ye? Sad day today. Oh no. Why a sad day? Oh my gosh. I'm gonna have to turn this off. Phone. Apologies. Did I hear? Oh, what, about the Queen? Or about something else? Oh, this is a jackal trap.
The side-striped jackal sticks to the woods and the scrub, scavenging from other predators or negligent campers. Unless fruit is in season. When there's fruit, that's all Mhumbi eats. Consider them gentle predators.
The sidestruck jackal is mostly nocturnal, opportunistic omnivore. Oh, I missed the rest of that. I heard the news about the Queen. It is quite sad. I'm not a staunch monarchist, neither am I a staunch anti-monarchist. But, you know, from where I'm sat, love her or hate her, she was an important part of British life. She was an important British political figure. So yeah, it is kind of a little sad that she is gone. And even though, I was saying earlier, even though logically I knew it's going to happen while I'm alive, I didn't sort of really believe that I would ever actually have it happen while I was alive, you know? If you'd asked me 10 years ago, who will die first, you or the Queen? My head would have said the Queen, but my heart would definitely have said me. We are getting close to where El Springo Boko was. Anyway, that's why we're doing a little tour of reserves that I don't normally stream in, that are in Commonwealth countries. Or are probably in Commonwealth countries in the case of Vahunga, because it's not in any one definite country. Springboko? Hang on, hit me hooter. You about, or did you move off? You might have moved off. Oh, he was actually downwind of me, which I didn't realize. He didn't give out a warning call. Unless he did it while I was momentarily away checking my bloody phone. There's quite a few tracks. No spin box. Guess he's moved on. What time is the zone active? Oh, hello. Maybe spoke too soon. There they are. Oh my god, there's quite a few of them actually.
Our old friend, the Bronking Springbok. Harvesting springbok is a reliable way to feed local markets and prevent overgrazing, if you can catch them.
Mm-hmm. Mating call is good, it means he doesn't know I'm here. Which I don't know exactly where he is either. I'll hit the heater again. Where did you go? Where did you go? Springboks? Springboks? Ow! Oh, I thought he was dead. No, okay, I need the one. Oh, he didn't get far. Wow, he traveled just far enough to hit me. And no further. Oh my gosh, that's another gold. Wow. I'm quite happy with that. Oh, there they go. Oh my god, that's so many of them. That's a melanistic one. I don't think we're gonna necessarily have time to sneak all the way up on him and actually catch him today. Which is super unfortunate. If I had a longer range rifle that was capable of taking springboks, I'd absolutely snipe it. I'd probably have sniped him from there, to be honest. Oh, actually, if he's not running away any further, because some of them seem to have stopped. Hello? You lost your gang account. What's your gang account? Why were you in a gang? Moving further away. Don't do that. Come back. Hang on. I'll hit the hooter again. What's the range on my hooter? It's a rare gang named PFP account. I don't think I know what PFP is. No, stop running away. Guys. Guys. I wish I had a bloody proper rifle. I'm in an Aussie gang. Oh, I did know that you're in an Aussie gang, actually. I did. Don't be in a gang! They're bad for you. They're bad to your health. I know I was in a gang in my Yu-Gi-Oh stream, but that's a card game gang. That's different. Also, I didn't have a choice. Also, my character was trying to get out of a gang, which is why we joined the actual bad guys. No, I didn't want to attract you. Oh, now it held me open with no cover. And there's a springbok coming for me. Gotta get into a bush. Yours is named TLB. What does that stand for? I really wish I had a blade. Or a proper rifle. Okay. I think we might be able to kite around that guy. We have, however, lost that springbok in the process. The loyal bloods. Why? Need to get closer to this guy, wherever he is, without alerting that one. I realize I'm speaking in my soft, dizzy voice that I do whenever I'm like in a tense hunting moment in this game. Not a bad gang, okay. We don't want you in any bad gangs. What's that? That's actually the Tower of Woody's. There's some of you over there. A melanistic one was sort of more over this way. Okay. Having a little nibble. Over there. I'm surprised, honestly, that he isn't freaking out that I'm this close. So I'm within 70 meters of him. That's pretty close. So I'm surprised he isn't very upset. But as long as he's not very upset, I'm gonna let him be not upset. I'm going to, in fact, take full advantage of him being not upset. Don't, however, know where this black one has gone. It's not you.
Hey, little hare.
Oh, this is a hare.
Mfundla. Like the savannah and the scrubs, as their name obviously suggests, they breed during droughts, and we've had plenty of droughts, so you'll find them zigging and zagging all over.
What? Black brown. Oh, okay, you might actually not be melanistic. You might just be black brown. That would be kind of disappointing. If I think that's the one that you were. Not a different springbok. You might have gone over that way. This is a decision moment. Okay, we'll keep following this way. Based on the fact that... I don't know, based on what fact? It's not based on fact, it's based on it's easier to keep doing what I'm already doing than it is to change to do something else. That's what it's based on. Oh, I never checked what time these zones are active. They're active until 11. Apparently all of the arrows. Oh, blimey, what's that? That's a springbok mating call, okay. That's a good sign. It means we can't be that far away. Oh, this might be a new feeding zone. That does not sound like the noise I just heard. This is a hair feeding zone. Night. I don't know what that noise was. The springy box. No, that's the jackal. No, the springy box. I feel like this isn't a very springy footprint. What's that noise? Why are none of these noises something that's suddenly identified? Where did this blooming springbok go? Oh, there he is. Oh, there's a springbok. Nope, he spotted me. So I stopped to identify him. What was that? That's okay, so that's black brown, so that's not the one that I initially identified as being possibly melanistic. However, does that mean that we've gone entirely the wrong way? And we've been following completely the wrong set of springbok? I think it might do. Gosh darn me and my weapon choice. Oh, it'll be fine, I'll just cover everything from 1 to 3 with a shotgun. Yeah. Shotgun, fine. Honestly. On Hirschfelden, real close range stuff. Not a lot of sight lines. Out here, I definitely need a rifle. In fact, even the king might be a bit ambitious. But we're bringing it along for other reasons. Okay. Where are you? I think you're just over there. Possibly. To reload this thing. Yes, okay, that's the melanist. He was now running away. Don't know. He ran away. I should have taken the shot. Wait, does this have an effective range of 50 meters? No, effective range 25 meters. Should have taken the shot. I was a fool not to take the shot, in fact. It's fine. Oh, there's loads of springbok here. There you are. Why is this zeroed to 50 meters? Weird. Okay. That one. Come back. Oh, it's downwind of me, which isn't helping. You are just a bit far away. Come 36 meters. Nope. Meters, definitely nope. I'm much more on board with the long tricky hunts in the Hunter than I am with the long tricky catches in the Angler. Maybe that's slightly hypocritical. Although, actually, the long, difficult hunts in the Hunter don't cause me physical pain. you coming back? At all? Don't know, it's difficult to see. One over here top. A little unfortunate. It's nearly half past, which is when I was sort of intending to change over. However, I'd like to see this hunt through to either an end where he gets away, or an end where I take it down. Oh my gosh. 60 meters. And we found a new feed zone as well. That's good news. Means he's moving slow. Well, that means he's not moving. I can slowly sneak up. Let's actually mark him on the map. So I've got a rough idea of the distance to him, even when I can't see him. Also, we found loads of these feed zones as we've gone past. Okay, I want to be around to this side a bit more. Hell. I might be one between me and him. That's not good. I've heard people. Not good people, but I've heard people who play the game refer to the females that generally stick around males as bodyguards. Because the sorts of people who kind of only play this game to kind of hunt males and get trophies. Hell, where is he? There, okay. I'm nearly in range. To that sort of person, the only way the females sort of interact with them in the game, because they don't want to hunt the females. So they think the females are sort of just there to be things that will let out warning calls and scare off the males. But in this case, it does feel a little bit like I've got to saunter through a field of other springbok. Not saunter, stealth through a field of other springbok who are all looking out for me. Oops, I nearly gave myself away there. Okay, he's in range. He's sighted. I'm perfectly side on. Dying. And he's now in range. You're in range. Not for long. I was a bit slow on the draw there, but we got the one we were after. Oh, you are black-brown. You're not melanistic. After all of that, you're quite a normal colour, look, you've even got a white face. Gosh darn it. Oh well, that's fine. It taught us a lot about hunting springbok. Well, we haven't spent... I don't feel like we spent that long here, but it probably would be quite a good moment for us to... Is there anything nearby that's of interest before we head over? No. That's probably a good moment for us then to switch over to... Excuse you. Don't at me. Thank you. A good moment to switch over to Te Awaroa, which is the other place I wanted to go today. Oh, we've missed this. That's fine. Oh, that was a hunting stand that I sort of saw off in the distance. So, let's head back to the main menu. Check how the stream is doing, because it's not always very happy. Select reserve. First of all, I'm annoyed that it doesn't give you the map view here. I'd much rather have the map view to select from. And we are going to New Zealand, nestled at the foot of the Southern Alps. Te Awaroa National Park is home to the diverse biomes of New Zealand's South Isle. Sika deer roam the lush, temperate beech of forests of the west, while red and fallow deer are found in the hillsides of the east. I've realised I haven't fixed my kit, but it's probably fine. Further up, chamois and feral goats play atop alpine ridges. Trace the trails of history from the first Polynesian settlers to the Harvey helicopter hunters, who took on great personal risks to preserve the reserve's unique biodiversity. Or just stop and take in the magic with landscapes that have inspired countless fantasy worlds. Oh yeah, we're going to Lord of the Rings, guys. I'm very sad that they mentioned Harvey helicopter hunters. But haven't... There's obviously nothing like even close to being like helicopter hunting in the game. That is a sweet picture of that dog, I guess. The Hunter Calls the Wild, established 2017. Equipment unlocked. True Vision Tritium Sights. Model Sal 12. I'm feeling a little like I'm stuck and not supposed to be wherever I am. Hello? Game? Game?
Kia ora. No mai haere mai ki Aotearoa. Welcome to New Zealand and to Te Awaroa National Park. This little slice of paradise is teeming with creatures big and small, and more adventures than you'll find on any movie screen or storybook. Now I've lived out here in the Wop Wops all my life.
The Wop Wops? Anything else.
In fact, it's practically in my blood. This place and my family go way back.
Ah, just like in the last reserve.
It's been a little tricky lately, though. It's fast becoming somewhere I don't recognize anymore, and I don't like it. That's why I dragged you out here, whore. With your help, we're going to wean ourselves off outside money and make the Awaroa model for sustainability the entire South Island can get behind.
Oh, I see. This was actually just a really slow, sweeping aerial shot in. That's what confused me. Okey-doke. Plop. Right. I'm in Glencalloch. Where is Glencalloch? Kind of at the bottom. Rakaiti.
Glad to see you've arrived in one piece.
Yep.
Josh is my nephew. He just got his license. And I swear that kid spends more time with his hands on the radio dials than on the steering wheel. I hope he didn't talk your ear off. I've had to rely on him a lot lately since my legs started acting up again. I was planning to head out and meet you today, but here I am at home, propped up on five kinds of pillows. Ah, doctor's orders. Anyway, that's enough chit-chat from me. Head over to the outpost marked on your hunter mate and let's get you started.
Well, there's never been an excuse for why they can't come and see me in person before. We're not going to a tower to start with. We're just going to an outpost?
I hope you had a chance to spend some quality time on your own before I rang you up. Your mate, Alejandra, said the two of you were here on holiday?
Were we? Who's Alejandra?
Nothing but praise for you, by the way. Said you almost single-handedly turned things around for her in Cuatro Colinas.
Oh, okay, I see. She's someone from a reserve I haven't played.
Let's take our time getting to know each other first. I'll admit that it wasn't just her recounting your heroic antics that made me pick up the phone. She said you were, and I quote, stoic, practical, and probably born out in the bush somewhere. Just what I was looking for, in other words.
Ooh, I like these trees. I don't know what kind of tree they are, but I like them. Okay, so this is, I guess, a little bit of a weird story. In that it's dumped me in post Cuatro Colinas, even though I've never played it. Which I wasn't expecting. But I suppose that's good to know in that whenever I come to properly stream this park, I'll want to do it after I've done in Quattro Colinas. For now, though, we're only here on a little tour. So I'm off to go nab an outpost and fix my kit. What animals are here? I should be checking this. Well, we've got free time. That's my gun. Tewarara. We've got red deer, class 6. We have seeker, fallow, and feral pigs, who are all class 4. Chamois and feral goats are all class 3. And then we have turkeys and rabbits, that are class 1s. Oh, okay. Interesting. So this is like a real low class reserve. The British will actually be really good here because it hits class 4s really hard and we have 3 different class 4s. I'll want to swap out the king because there's nothing that uses the king here. And in its place, I guess... Oops.
Evidence you're not alone out there.
Yes, thank you for telling me how tracks work, game. What the blue blazing bucket of bolts was that? A turkey call. I can't call back. Let's get me... No, let's... Where's me... What button am I looking for? Let's get me birdshot on. Now, are turkeys something that has to be flying when I shoot them? I don't know. Also, I feel like turkeys as a bird aren't going to leave lots of tracks on the ground. So tracking a turkey might be quite difficult. That's a tree fern. That's very exciting. I tell you what else, this is quite close quarters. This is more like Hirschfelden from the tiny amount of it that I've seen. Turkey. You sounded really loud, so I'm expecting you to be close. Turkey? Oh, blimey. Jesus Christ. Turkey. Okay. You're going to be damn near impossible to actually hit with a gun, aren't you? I'm going to sneak through that tree, and there's going to be a turkey, and I'm going to fire blindly into the air and miss it, I think. Should I be moving more slowly than this? Oh, that's a fallow deer. Hello. Are you close? You are. I'll take you instead. Well, I won't if you do that, though. Blast. I don't think I hit it. I shouldn't have taken the shot. I was greedy. Oh my god, I did hit it as well. Right, let's run over here. See if that turkey's still around. Oh my god, there's loads of them. Well, that's exactly what I expected to happen with the turkeys. Hello? Are you just gonna stand there? Okay. Well, we'll find out if you need to be in the air for me to get a good trophy from you. No, you don't! I pass a harvest check anyway. Oh, okay. Well, that's easier. Then I won't scare any of you into the air again. Thanks for just standing around and being shot, I guess. where did that... Where was that deer? Deer? Oh god, I've just blobbed a huge amount of hunting pressure on the ground, haven't I? Where did the deer go? There's the deer. It's fine. Probably. Those turkeys I probably actually could have got with a bow and arrow. You're spotted pattern, apparently. Oh, I hit you quite far back. I knew I was going to hit you quite far back. That's why I didn't think it was going to be a good shot. But apparently the 303 British is just powerful enough to take you down straight away from a bloomin' liver-stomach shot. Oh no, I did hit lung as well. Oh wow. That's actually a really tight line through all three of those organs that I could not have made on purpose if I was trying to. Okay. I'm quite happy with that for a first kill. First three kills, in fact. Why is the wind blowing? Southwest. It's good to bear that in mind. Welcome to New Zealand! Bang! That's a very pretty bird song. Meep, 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 meep. That was a terrible impression, but I could whistle it, but I don't think anyone wants me whistling down my mic. I mean, I've never tried whistling down my mic. I don't know that it's not a pretty sound, but like, it's not a pretty sound. The particular species of tree around here make this feel almost a more primeval environment. More primordial environment, perhaps, than Hirschfelden. Like, stuff like that, and the tree fern, and the proliferation of conifers. Is that a circus? What the hell? Okay, I know. I'm assuming that's that. Okay, I know we're supposed to be going to the outpost, and I know I do want to fix my kit, but... I really want to check out the circus. I hope we're not hunting animals from the circus. No, wait, that's not the circus. That's something over here. Also, I'm not certain if it is just circus, because this looks like a... This actually might be like a Ren Fair, because it's got a sort of a medieval banner type thing. I don't actually know if Renfair is the correct term to use outside the US, but I follow enough US media that I've heard it referred to as a Renfair often enough that that's my go-to I think to make a D's Nuts joke, you have to... there has to be setup first. You love your name? I'm pleased for you. It was set up. Oh, hello, what are you? You're another fellow, dear. I don't actually know what the range on this is. I've just been assuming it's 150, it's 115. Hello. There's another fellow, dear. Let's get a little closer, see if you have... Get a big red deer. I will definitely look out for one. See if there's anyone else in your herd. Would be around 103. Is that for a diamond red deer? Oh, I've lost where those bloody fallow deer were. Over here. Oh, hello. What are you? You're a male, female, female. There's someone through there I can't see properly. I'm quite happy taking a shot from here, I think. I pop off the male and the female right in front of him. There we go. Know the range. Oh, the effective range on this. Oop. Well, there's another fellow deer over there somewhere. Look down the hill. Where's that? You know, I'm kind of tempted. Can I crouch, please? Anything. I can't see him. Let me spot him. There, oh, there, up. Oh. Okay, it's fine. Jesus, this thing hits hard. This thing packs a massive punch. Like, these guys were dropped on the spot from just regular old double lungs, not even particularly close. Zooming in out really fast when having that problem. Yeah, I know the trick. I just try not to have to use it when I'm not, like, directly about to take the shot, because it doesn't sort of like stay in your sights, if you see what I mean. I've totally lost track of where this bloody circus is. I think I've gone past it, actually. I've gone past the circus. Fall idea was over here somewhere. If there are, in fact, any fallow deer left alive in New Zealand after a rampage that I'm going on today. Right, hello. Lovely. Oh, that was a heart shot. Oh, come on. More fallow deer? Am I even going to get to an outpost today, or am I just going to chain hunt fallow deer forever? I wish fallow deer were this abundant in Hirschfelden. Incidentally, we're very far away from Hirschfelden. How come there are fallow deer here and there? What's up with that? Did we import them? Or are they just two different species that we both call fallow deer? Oh, I don't have a call for fallow deer because my kit is unfixed. Oh, hello. How close are you? A bit close. You're class 4, so I could actually shotgun you, theoretically. Sorry, but Hirsch is the worst map for real. I mean, I enjoy walking through it, it's still very pretty. And I think the animal selection in Hirsch is better than the animals. Oh, cack. I just spooked her. And that will speak to everyone else. I think the animal selection in Hirsch is better than the animal selection in Medved, which is the other one I've been playing on stream. So I can't really complain about it too much. I find the terrain annoying to hunt through sometimes, because it's not as open as this. It's really closed off. If anything, I'd say it's the most closed off map that I've experienced so far. And that's perhaps why I'm a bit more successful with something like the King than I would be elsewhere. Where are you? Oh, you're right in the middle. Can you move off? I actually kind of want to scare you off just a bit so that you run further away. Oh, I didn't even realize you were that close. Just so that you're not splatting all this hunting pressure of the feed zone, which will destroy the feed zone. Ideally, I don't want to scare you off too far, if you catch me. Like, you've got to be close enough that I can still find you and shoot you. But not so far, but not so close that you're within about 150-ish meters of this. I don't know the exact range that hunting pressure spreads, but it's like about that. I suspect what's actually going to happen is you're just going to run off. But that's kind of okay. You know, it's not like we haven't just harvested a whole bunch of fallow deer. And I know I'm probably being too fussy about preserving my meat zones. But damn it, they're a lot of work to find sometimes. Any feed zone that's not near water is random chance or a lot of work to actually find. So I'm going to take good care of him where I can. And having already stacked three kills on top of one another just over there, I don't feel like I need to do it again over here. Kai Power Peninsula. We're not a peninsula? Well, I suppose. Not really. We're not really on the peninsula, but okay. Oh, I'm turkeys again. Unfortunately, I'm just back the way I've come. Don't want to double back on myself. Where did the fallow deer go? Did they go off that way or did they go further in this direction? I'm hoping they went further in this direction. So I can pick them up after I've tagged this. But I suspect they might not have. Oh well, that's fine. We'll still have a look at the Ren Fair slash circus. Oh, you might have gone off that way. This surely can't be the flag for the Ren Fair, can it? It's really far away. Well, it's not really far away, but like... you'd expect it to be right next to it.
We got a little overly reliant on these tent pole releases. Well, I say more tents and fewer releases. Does that work? Nah, you're right.
You what? I don't understand the words you just said then, I don't think. Filmmaking is a lucrative industry in New Zealand, with annual screen revenue of over $3 billion New Zealand dollars. In 2018, profit is highly concentrated. The Auckland region accounts for over 50% of screen revenue in a given year. I don't know where Auckland is within New Zealand, so that doesn't really let me know very much. The majority of revenue is still generated by domestic contracts. This is steadily decreasing. 2016, about a third of gross revenue was international, with 90% coming from North America. Tourism has grown in kind, with sleepy rural areas featured in films transformed into major attractions almost overnight. Oh, I see. So this isn't a Ren Fair, it's a set that somebody has put up and then just abandoned, I guess. It's not a terribly convincing movie set. Maybe it would be in shot, I don't know. Maybe it's just for, like, incidental transition shots, who knows. I would be a little bit surprised if there wasn't a collectible in it. And it looks like at least some of the fellow deer have gone this way. So let's definitely head in and check the place out. Oh, and it's raining. Hello. Splishy, splashy, splishy, splashy. Let's actually explore this on foot. Did we get into any of the tents? No. No. There's a barrel of, I'm assuming, fake oranges that are particularly low poly, it must be said. Look at that octagonal orange. I'd be very excited if I found an octagonal orange in real life. Ooh, there's a script. I bet it says Lorem Ipsum. No, it doesn't say Lorem Ipsum. Hey, Hunter. I hope to do more business with you soon. Good luck. What does this say? I think my texture quality is good enough to read that. I'm gonna turn my texture quality up for a sec, even though this might really tank the screen, the stream. Give us a sec. What do I need? Texture resolution, ultra. Maybe I was there, or maybe where? Lollipop? Up. Something. Open. Twattery out. I have. There's scientific sack. Make with jewel. I'm not convinced. I wonder what the hell is going on there. Okay, I can understand why there's a piece of paper that has blurry text on it, but why does it also have almost legible text, but in white? On the same asset. Maybe that's for a mission thing later. I don't know. It's very suspicious is what it is. Oh, I should have a look over there while I can still see it because I'm still up. Hello. Another fallow deer. God, it's just not your day, is it, you guys? Oh, hello, there's someone over there. Unless that was the track, that was the track.
A wild turkey population of descendants of runaways from nearby farms. Unlike in the States, there are few natural predators out here. Local hunters don't go for them, so they're yours for the taking.
Why do the local hunters not go for them? There's good eating in the turkey. You on your own. Little fallow deer, you do look like it. Oh, there's another one. I think there might be another one as well. There we go. Okay, there's three of you. Maybe a fourth one? Yes! You've got a male with you. Okay. What distance? 200 meters. Ideally, I want to be a bit closer than that. So I guess I'm heading up to this bit of grass. Do-do-do, sneaky dizzy, committing genocide against fallow deer. She hasn't come up with any interesting facts about fallow deer, has she? When I clicked on their tracks. I don't remember her saying any anyway. But I wanna know why there are fallow deer here and in Germany. On the opposite sides of the world. I'm just thinking about the hunger. There is a class 1 to 3 rifle. It is supposed to be phenomenally bad at actually hitting anything above class 1. Like, not the accuracy bit, but the stopping power bit. Right, okay, I'm going to take you and then you. Oh, not if... Well, it's like, get the waypoint off the screen. You and then the one next to you. Might have aimed a bit high on that second one. Well, that does look like a two splat though. So I might have got her. If you aim high enough, you end up with a good shot again because you hit the spine. Right. One body, two bodies. So she didn't get far. Right, bop. Confirm trophy. Oh, that was very high. That was nearly a spine shot though, blimey. That's okay. I find that it's quite hard to hold the 303 steady for your second shot. It's obviously not designed for follow-up shots. And would definitely impede the British Army tactic of, quote, constant withering fire. You were taken very nicely. Quite happy with that. I'm going to see if that other fallow deer that just made a call is still about. I suppose that's the other thing though, the other reason to have a shotgun on, even if it's not ideal for the hunger, is to get the score up. Hello? Oh my god, you guys really just sort of stood here. Oh, you're very close. Very close. That thing. I kind of want to scare you off a bit more. Well, okay, no, what I actually want to do is shoot you with a bow and arrow, but I don't have one. And the outpost is 200 meters away, and you'll be gone by the time I come back. So we won't do that. Might instead. I could try and deliberately scare you away. Okay, we'll try and run to the outpost, see if we can grab a bow and arrow in time. We won't. But we'll give it a good old go. Or possibly we'll get distracted by something else along the way. Or maybe you're going to move off. Oh, you're moving off on your own. Okay. That's acceptable. You move further away, then I can follow you without hassle. Spook you on purpose. Where are you headed? Don't head off that way. That's like the opposite of the way I want you to go. I was fine when you were heading off that way. Don't go that way. Okay. Are we gonna give chase? No. I haven't gone very far, have they? Are we going to give chase? I know I'm terrible at making decisions. Or rather, I'm very good at making, saying I'm going to do one thing, and then saying I'm going to do something else 20 seconds later. That's my superpower. It's called ADHD. Cry. Which way did you go? You did go this way. Annoying deer. How far have you gone? Have you run real far? You might have run real far. Actually. In which case I won't bother you, Chase. I'll just turn around. It's cost me 50 meters of travel. You seem to. Oh, hello. Oh, there's a turkey feed zone. There's lots of turkeys. All class 1 trivial. You're a class 2 minor. Okay. Guess we'll aim for you then. Right, we can blast 2 turkeys on here, which is fine because that's how many rounds we have in the chamber. Check I've still got birdshot on. We do. I think I might have been planning to shoot the fallow deer with a shotgun earlier and have not changed it away from birdshot and actually still have buck. Still have just unloaded around the birdshot into a fallow deer, which. Oh, you're shiny and white, but I don't know if that's an unusual colour. If you... I don't want to make the mistake I made last time of, chasing a unusually coloured turkey only for it to not be that unusual. I kind of want to sneak into this bush, but I don't know if this turkey's going to let me. Or if he's too wily for that. Well, you seem to be spotting me. I miss my Virant. I really do. Uh-oh, one of them is flying away. That's not... Oh, they're all flying away. Maybe the other two will not, because they didn't seem to be as worried. And crucially, maybe the bigger one will still be around. Because that was only 2, and it weren't, that wasn't the difficulty 2 turkey. So I might be in luck. Emphasis might. Of course, if I'd fixed my kit and I had a turkey caller, then this would have been less of an issue. But I didn't do that. I was like, no, let's go chase fallow deer and turkeys instead. Hello? Hello? Are you here? Did you all leave? Did you all just leave in a different direction to the other two? You might have done. Blast. Well, that was a waste of time. Okay, so the turkeys are a little more wily than I gave them credit for. Even if they are still leagues less flighty than ducks or geese. Hmm. These are apparently Merriam turkeys. Whatever that means. Are they definitely gone? Yeah, they definitely. It's a shame. Oh well. We'll head back. Gotta tag this outpost. What time is it? It's 2:05. Gosh, have we really only been in New Zealand for about 40 minutes? I feel like this has been a very packed 40 minutes. Compared to the time we spent in the Hunger. I can feel the traditional Call of the Wild sleepiness setting in. Oh, hello. Another fellow deer. Poor soul. Do I have a fallow deer caller on me? I don't think I do. Oh, I do. I have the antler rattler. Might be worth deploying. I'm nowhere near any cover. Don't necessarily want them too close to me just yet. Those are my tracks. Okay, might be hitting away. Play the rattler. Oh, that upset you. You didn't like antler rattling. Oh, he's downwind of me, that's what's the problem. Looks like you've got a feed zone here. It's going to be an interesting shot, but I'll take it. God, this thing is devastating. I mean, to be fair, it's probably no more devastating than any other rifle that caps out at class 8 would be on a class 4. The difference is I'm allowed to use the C on class 4. Look, that was like a grazing lung shot, and he still went down almost instantly. Where's the tracking distance? Apparently 103 meters. I don't feel like I tracked you for 103 meters, but there we go. Oh, that's just a little spit of land there. Is this the sea? I suppose it must be. But if this is the sea, I wouldn't expect to see drinking zones here. Oh, there's a lookout tower, not on the little peninsula, but somewhere beyond it over there. Look, and I can see the roof of the outpost. Oh. Is that bit of land something I can get to? It's like the edge of the map. So technically yes, but in practice I probably won't ever go there. Oh, look, we've got phantom trees. Our friends. That's another invasive species from Germany. Oh, I've accidentally minimized the game. I've lost myself. Where are we? There we are.
Not far now. We built these outposts in the early 90s. They got the works, repurposed materials, solar roofs, rainwater tanks. That was back when people used to just call you a hippie. Now everything's sustainable, clean, green, eco-friendly. Hippies. Ha! Try trailblazers.
Oh, I kind of like her. I mean, people still kind of call you a hippie if you want to put solar panels on stuff. So, we're not quite where she thinks we are just yet. Well, that's very interesting how the quest marker ticks down ever so slightly at a different time to the actual location marker. Let's see, okay, I'm 100 meters away from the quest, but only 99 meters away from the thing. I should have brought chocolate biscuits up with me, because they would have given me like a little sugar kick to keep me going and wake me up.
And good for the environment doesn't have to mean bad for your back. It's pretty cozy inside. Go on, take a look.
Thank you for reminding me to check my posture. I don't actually know what your name is. What's your name is? What's your name is? What is your name? Kiri Taylor. I've got lots of things to do in this mission. Enter the outpost, then visit lookout tower, and then pick up the action camera. What the hell is the action camera? Oh, you know what I've also not done is take a picture of New Zealand, which I should probably do. Maybe I'll do it at some point. Or maybe I'll do it when I grab a lookout tower, actually, they're normally good picture spots. Okay. Oh, the quest actually wants me to go inside, okay. It looks like there's a bunch of different cabins. Hello? Oh! Okay, that genuinely spooked me.
I see we got company.
That really properly spooked me.
Just as well you get used to it. I'll fill you in later.
Oh my god.
Strap it to your chest and let me explain what exactly.
No, actually I don't.
There's a lookout tower not far away. So you can head up there and get a sense of the place while I flap my gums.
Where the hell is this camera? Oh, it's this thing that looks like a bow and arrow.
Nice and tight now. Wouldn't want it coming off right when you've got a shot lined up.
Wait, this camera is bound to my chest? God, that's terrifying. Can I get out this door? I can, okay. I don't have to push past them all the time. Oh, we've got a little bug zack as well. Right. Oh, have I now got to go all the way back? I have got to go all the way back. Bloody hell. We may or may not do that on stream, I don't know. I want to go get a good picture for my Te Awaroa transition screens when I eventually stream here. Because I've got like a couple... I've got one actually... wide shot from the a screenshot from the zoom in. So that might be enough. Where am I? What am I looking for? Oh, I was looking through my screenshots like an idiot. Oh, I wanted to fix my kit! Yes! Okay, so we don't need the king. Where's the king? Where's the king? Bye bye, king. We love you, but you aren't actually very helpful here. We do want. We don't need you. And at the moment, we don't need the site that goes on the king, which is this one, because nothing else we have can use that at the moment. We do want a rifle that takes, ideally classes 1 to 3, or 1 upwards. So the .22H takes 1 to 2. Do we have any class 3s here? We do. We don't have any class... Okay, we have classes 3, 4, 5, and 6. And we don't have any 2, and we have 2 different class 1s. .22LR truncated cone bullet. Oh! I didn't realize that unlocked these. So these are the polytip equivalents to the firent bullets that I'm used to using. .270 soft points. I should actually be checking all of these, hang on. .223 is 2 to 4. You're 1 to 2. You're class 1. You're 2 to 6. 2 to 6. 4 to 8. 4 to 8. 2 to 6. 7 to 9. 4 to 8. 4 to 8. 7 to 9. 2 to 4. Can I check here? Yes, 7 to 9. 4 to 9. 9. 4 to 8. And 4 to 9. I don't have anything that hits the 1 to 3 range. Well, that's real annoying. I'm going to grab the Virant. I love the Virant. It's one of my favorite. It's not one of my favorite guns, but I'm going to grab it anyway. Oh, I've got a crossbow. Ooh. I could take a crossbow because they've got a much longer range than the regular bow. But they are, well, they're heavier, but they're not heavier than the fancy ones. They're only heavier than the basic ones. I've not crossbow hunted in ages. Let's grab the crossbow. I need bolts for it. 420 gram broadhead bolt. 600 gram broadhead bolt. I think there should be one more class of bolts that I need to buy, perhaps. Hawk and crossbow scope. Store. Arrows. 300 gram of small game point tracer bolts. Yeah. How many of these do I have? 53 and 59. I've got loads. But we're buying tracers from now on. Although it's less important than when we're using the regular bow. Yeah, okay, so we've now got a shotgun that'll deal with the ones that our 308 won't at close range, and we've got the crossbow that will deal with them at slightly longer range. I think the effective range... See, it says effective range 30 meters. I feel like it's actually useful up to 60 meters. I feel like I've been using it up to 60 meters. We don't have a rangefinder scope for this, sadly. And I need to fix my callers as well. Storage. Callers? Where's my callers? There we go. Right, we don't have any boar here. No, we do. We have feral pigs. We need a... Do we have any predators here? We don't have any predators here. So weirdly, we don't need that. Or that. Seeker deer are here, so we'll keep you. You grab fallow deer, we already need that. What else do we have? Red deer, feral goat, and turkey. Well, you also tag seeker deer, so we'll bring you along. Red deer. Is there such a thing as a goat caller? I don't know. You grab Merriam turkey. You also grab Merriam turkey. What is the difference between the two of you? So these get them to vocalize, and these get them to come, I think. Not like that. Right, callers. Duck caller. You're also for seeker deer. We seem to have lots of things that can attract seeker deer. We'll bring them all along just in case. Doesn't look like we have anything that will attract goats. That's okay. Yeah, grunt caller. Okay. We've got a lot of callers on us. Right. Weapons. Crossbow on number 4, which is where bows go. Ammo. Oh, I didn't bring that. I didn't move the ammo out of storage. Hang on. We have a. There's a lot of arrows and bolts that look very similar. Let's trace an arrow. I don't want to trace an arrow. I want to trace a bolt. I've got the crossbow scope. Okay, that might be everything. We'll stick on the... this. That's just for turkey, basically. So we'll stick on this for now. We've got birdshot in the chamber for you. Sights, you need your crossbow scope. Lures. Oh my god, we've got so many. I don't know if any of these are like off target or main target. Wild turkey crow call. Well, okay, so you theoretically we've got one thing on here on our hotbar that attracts everything apart from turkeys. So let's try this. Wild turkey mouth caller. Or number that. Number that. That's how numbering systems work. Do we have any pretty pictures to take? What's over here? Not super duper feeling it. I'll take one just in case. Let's click to take, not enter. Okay. Right, then I guess we might as well head over to the outpost. So I guess the storyline here involves us taking lots of pictures, which is nice. It's nice to have, you know, things that focus on the other parts of the game. I've mentioned this several times on stream. How long have we got left? About half an hour. Don't know if we're going to make a 1 kilometer journey in half an hour. But it would be nice to get to the outpost just so we can, you know, take some nice snapshots and have our first outpost unlocked. I did wonder why it didn't send us to an outpost at the start. This is why. It's going to send you back there. Once you've already gone a million miles in the wrong direction. This doesn't look like a beach. This doesn't look like a coastline, does it? So maybe that's not the sea. Maybe it's just a really large lake, like the nebulously large lakes that surround a bunch of the other maps. Oh, excuse me, I got a cough. Apologies. Also, apologies to people who get distressed by seeing Little Dizzy going absolutely haywire in the bottom left when you can't hear anything. Little Dizzy, she is plugged into a different mic than real life Dizzy. For reasons that are beyond me. Beyond the ken of mortal being, in fact. We are also, because we're retreading ground that we sort of mostly already covered as well, which isn't ideal. But I mean, hey, it's not like New Zealand hasn't been good to us. Let's get the crossbow. No, that's not the crossbow. So this is what the crossbow looks like. It's a little bit annoying in that you've got to load it every time you zoom in. So it's got quite a long zoom in animation. I sort of thought that one of the points of crossbows was that you could kind of keep them knocked before you shot them. But our hunter obviously hasn't heard of this concept. And you know, like, maybe you can't necessarily keep them knocked for ages and ages and ages. But it would be nice if I could keep them knocked for... Oh god, there's a wasp in my room. It would be nice if I could keep them knocked for long enough that, like, I could do it between aims. Yeah, sometimes I want to do this, and with a crossbow, that then becomes this whole rigmarole. Turn it off, unload it, and unload it, and oh my god. Look, he's barely away from his eye and he's already reaching. That's just me mucking about. I got all excited then, because I thought I heard a goat noise, but I think it's just a bird. We are, perhaps unsurprisingly, not seeing very much of anything. It's about midday. But I don't know what that means in practice. Interestingly, this lookout tower isn't on a road or path. I find that kind of surprising. Oh no, it's on a path, it's just this brown colour that blends almost seamlessly into the rest of the map. Well, this is the problem with making fallow deer extinct. There's none of them to hunt anymore. What is this? Oh, you're out of my way. And you, if you're over there, you're in the mess of all of this, which I don't really want to be. Don't really want to be getting into, so we will leave you, sadly. Having just complained that there's no deer, we will then hear a deer and ignore it. Oh, we've come up on this. That was the turkey spot. That was a total failure. The turkeys were a failure after the fallow deer were previously a failure. Stacking failure on top of failure. When are they supposed to be used? They've just finished. They finished while I was fixing my kit, which is the only downside to fixing one's kit, because it takes time. Well, actually, the other downside is that I fixed my kit for Te Aroa. It's not particularly well fixed now for Hirschfelden when I go back. So there's the other downside. We'll probably be taking the king off. Stop being over there. Come, go stand there. Like, on that hill. In fact, go stand with your face touching the trunk of that tree, and your tail sort of about there-ish. Please. That's where I want you. It's like the perfect shot. I actually know what range that is. That's a pretty fine range. Of course, if we don't meet any animals, then crossing this kilometer distance becomes a lot more likely, because there'll be fewer distractions. Glen Calloc. New Zealand has a really weird mix of names. Like, this is a Scotland name. This is, I'm assuming, a native name. This is a native name. But then you've got other things like, Auckland and various things which are like, you know, other disparate European names or European sounding names. I don't know if Auckland is a place in Europe, but it certainly sounds very Europe. That fellow dude is desperate to be shot. It's over the other side of that hill though, so it's probably out of range of my caller. I'll give it a go. Wait, if I'm here to take pictures, is she going to be upset with me blasting everything in sight? Oh no, she said I was free to take the turkeys. So she must know I'm a hunter. She's not going to be like, why can I hear gunshots off in the distance? Curse me being stuck off here, my leg. And then she'll give me a mission, like, I heard someone firing a gun. Can you go and find out who it was? And it was just me. I described the terrain so far as Hirschfelden's less horrible cousin. Like, you can actually see pretty far, even through what is normally a forested area. I love that, that's great. I guess that must mean it's really heavily grazed. Bloody fellow, dear. I shouldn't have called you. You are 300 and something meters away. How can I even hear you? I mean, I couldn't hear you. I only saw the little soundbars coming up on my screen. But that's not the point. This looks like a field of Christmas trees, which is making me nervous. I hope this isn't pig country. I've opened my window to try and let the wasp out, and the wasp hasn't gone out. And instead of coming in, I can hear noises of some sort of a ruckus outside. So this has been like a double failure. Actually, it's a triple failure because it's making me a little touch chilly. Although maybe that'll at least keep me awake. Are you following me? You're going to be following me for a long time if you are. Oh god, has the hunt become the hunted? I was worried about being hunted by lions. I should have been worried about being hunted by fallow deer. Fallow deer armed with rifles. There? No. One over here? Never. Okay, the bounty of New Zealand has run out already. We have done a true colonialism and plundered all of the natural wilderness for its bounties and left it a desolate wasteland devoid of life, which is not what I intended to do on a sort of a we're sad about the queen dying stream, but is perhaps at least a little bit appropriate. Every time I hear that bird, I will respond with, like from Moulin Rouge. Well, this is the path. This is the path that will take us to that. We're not going to follow the path, we're just going to kind of plow straight through. But if we wanted to follow the path, there it is. I think that's interesting that my approach is so radically different. In the Angler, I will absolutely follow the paths. Partly that's because I'm driving everywhere. But actually, to be fair, when I'm driving in this game, I do tend to follow the paths. But yeah, most of the time in this game, I just go point to point. The shortest distance between any two points is a straight line. Tend to take it. Anyone on the road? I wouldn't expect it to hang out on the roads, but you never know. Oops, I've stopped. No, nobody. Well, it's quite an attractive looking path, it must be said. I mean, also, I suppose, like, I don't think animals in this game actually avoid paths and roads, but IRL animals would probably avoid the paths and roads at least a little bit, if there's any significant human traffic on them. I wonder when the timestamp of the last time I fired a shot was. I feel like it's quite a while ago now. It might well have been 20 minutes since I last saw an animal to take a shot at. I don't think I've even seen a track in that time. Okay.
Into a year-round retreat for hunters like you and Alejandra. So I don't spend most of the year worrying about whether our native plants are going to get overrun by deer again. There's a lot of filmmaking talent out here.
Hello.
And it hasn't been put to good use lately, if you ask me. So we're going to make a commercial? Show the world there's more to New Zealand than haka and halflings.
Oh, okay.
You're better to demonstrate the thrill of the chase in an experienced hunter like yourself.
Ah.
Prime was back in the 80s. Most of the other hunters out here are equally long of tooth. We need someone young, new, dynamic. You.
Am I young, new, and dynamic?
I'll do most of the work, so you just have to make sure it's on when you head out to hunt. We have a couple of strategic locations on our list to get through, but let's get you that view first.
I see. It's more like a body cam. Or a GoPro. That's basically what I'm wearing. I'm wearing a GoPro. We are going to stop off at this point of interest on the way. Mostly because I happened to spy it through my binoculars. And it looks like we're going to have time. We should be able to make this 200 meter trek in the next 20 or 18 minutes. So I don't think it'll be too much of a problem for us to wibble over this way. I don't know how long the mission chain is for these. I worry that some of the reserves might not have quite as many missions to do as Hirschfelden and Leighton, because they were the starting reserves that the game came with. Incidentally, speaking of the angler as I was earlier, kind of a little disappointed that it only comes with one reserve on release. I was expecting two, like this had Leighton and Hirschfelden. Actually, I don't know if it's had Leighton and Hirschfelden on release, but it certainly comes as standard with Leighton and Hirschfelden. So that was a little disappointing. And I suppose the flip side to that is that Golden Ridge Reserve is supposed to be a... Oh my god. Golden Ridge Reserve is supposed to be like one reserve that has a bunch of different areas that are kind of like small reserves in it. Oh, this is an outpost. And I'm like, okay. Why didn't I come here? Why did I go to the place with the stupid cave troll in the room that spooked the heck out of me? Why didn't I come here? And why didn't you leave the camera for me here? Also, this is really close to that tower. I was not expecting there to be an outpost this close to that lookout tower. Flag. There's supposed to be other stuff, not just a flag. There's supposed to be... Oh, it's sneakily hidden around here, I guess. Whatever that other thing is, we'll come to it in time. Guns welcome on premises. Such as judicious marksmanship is appreciated. What a thing to put on a sign. Judicious marksmanship is appreciated. Right. It's time to sell, I guess. Oh, not sell, but we're making an advert to sell. Am I wearing this camera all the time now in every reserve? Like, is she going to watch back all the footage of me hunting in Vahonga or something and be like, wow, we don't have anything nearly as cool as a lion here. Is she going to watch footage of me jumping off into that canyon in Hirschfelden and be like, such death-defying stunts, where was this recorded? And I'll be like, Germany. I'm really going to let her down, aren't I? Oh dear. Where are you guys? I'm a bit used to this, like going to a new area and there's not animals there when you first come. But I've been mostly backtracking. Like, I've been around this whole area the whole time anyway. I was not expecting it here. Ow. Can you actually see very much from the top of that tower? It doesn't look like it's particularly higher than the trees around it. Although that might just be my particular vantage point. Also, this is a really weird design of tower. It looks almost like a lighthouse.
There's the lookout tower, just up ahead.
And it's way more enclosed than the equivalent lookout towers in the other reserves. Which isn't a bad thing per se, but like, what advantages does this tower design have over the much less resource-intensive triangular wooden towers in Hirschfelden? I suppose it's taller. And actually, this is a lot more convenient to run up than the other tower designs are. Oh, it's got like a little... Oh, it's like a proper house thing in here. Okay. Power the fire extinguisher. A bottle of unknown substance. Cans of food goods. 100% natural. Gluten-free, sugar-free. Amount per serving, 90 calories from fat. And they've obviously set up this label wrong because this column says percent. Oh, I heard an animal then. Oh, that's a chamois. Oh, I'm busy. Hang on a sec.
Just take that in.
Yeah, I will. Where was the chamois?
Spectacular, isn't it? The all rolling hills and conifers. There's a line of mountains in the center of the reserve. Oh, and native beech forest, and a lot of rain on the other side.
That's nice. I'm looking for a little baby goat thing. Chamois?
Right, so remember Josh's little prank?
Yeah.
This place doesn't receive a lot of government funding, unfortunately, and a couple of years ago we were running out of money for field research, and the outposts were in need of sprucing up.
I mean, they're very spruced
they
up.
Made a deal with the devil, the Hollywood devil to be exact. Long story short, they've just wrapped up filming for the final movie they were contracted to do. Some fantasy thing, shiny blade or shimmering dagger or something. Now let me check. Ah, resplendent sword. I'll send you the blurb they gave me. My nephew tells
shiny
me it's a big
blade.
Deal, but I'd certainly never heard of it before this. But yeah,
oh my god,
nice
hello.
As it is, that Tialwador's beauty is up on the silver screen for all to see. It's come with its share of problems, to say the least. The bigwigs left in a hurry, and we got left with a bunch of basically intact movie sets scattered here and there all over the reserve.
Yeah, that does tend to happen.
Well, I'm telling you all of this because Josh just rang me up and said that he spotted another set on his way back. Not far from where I wanted you to try filming your first hunt. Could I trouble you to go clear it out?
Clear it out?
Run the risk of any of the props from the film featuring in our footage. Cheers.
Can we not? Is that a risk? Okay, we're not going to find that shell one, so might as well read this. Resplendent sword, the legendary blade has woken once more. An age of strife is upon us. Creatures of darkness, TM. Can you really trademark creatures of darkness? From a world beyond our own, we're in the land. Also, should you really be putting a trademark symbol on something that's not trademarked in your game? Roam the land, doing the bidding of the evil master, name. They literally needed a name, and they just put an accent on the E of name. Astonishing. When her peaceful forest village is sacked, a young human named Irona is taken prisoner and brought far into the mountains of the north. There she awakens the power of the legendary resplendent sword and becomes a bearer, assembling a ragtag group of allies from all races, including bears, to help her in her fight against the forces of darkness. How far is she willing to go to preserve the world she loves? Will she be able to defeat Name? Will she too succumb to the power of the sword she was destined to wield? from the renowned director of gripping period drama Our Daily Gruel and blockbuster hit The Retaliators TM Endless Strife comes this adaptation of R.J. Pine's classic novel Resplendent Swords, experience a breathtaking fantasy world where the forces of good and evil clash in spectacular cinematic set pieces. Marvel TM, as the latest innovation in practical effects and CGI come together to replay to Resplendia, astonishing, that exceeds your wildest imagination. I mean, if they're using innovative practical effects, that's actually a good thing, because that's the problem with movies nowadays, is there's almost no practical effects in them. Film background. Oh my god, there's quite a lot of this. Aeons ago, the world of Resplendia was a series of bickering... Why is this in the document? This is like nerd stuff, and I'm going to read it because I'm a nerd, and I'm going to read it on stream, because you'll better bloody be nerds if you're here. But why is this in the summary? Aeons ago, the world of Resplendia was a series of bickering petty kingdoms to be wrapped up in their own affairs and noticed the encroaching threat from the creatures of darkness. It was only after much cajoling from the Queen of Four Unities that the four races banded together to craft a weapon of legend to face them. Blueprints drawn up with much bluster by humans were realized with iron from the dwarves, forged in enchanted fire from the elves, and cooled with the purest water from the dwelling places of the merpeople. I feel like the merpeople are contributing the least here. This legendary blade shone brilliantly at all times and came to be known as the Resplendent Sword. Wielded by the legendary warrior Bryn, it cut down the creatures of darkness, banishing them to whatever shadowy realm they came from, restoring peace to the people at last. For one brief period, of 1,000 years or so, Resplendia was an idyll. Sword was handed down from hero to another, known as bearers, according to the cycle. Elves, humans, dwarves, the merpeople. Oh, so it's the Avatar. All good things must come to an end, however, and so it was when the evil elf Nain, entrusted with the great weapon, used its power to unleash the creatures of darkness on the world again. Okay, so Nain was like the bad bearer. Nain exists by the power he draws from the sword, but he cannot be called alive in any meaningful sense. The new bearer is out there, a human, just 19 as the film opens, in her peaceful forest village. When the village is destroyed by the creatures of darkness, after they refuse to hand over what little food they have left, she's taken as a recruit for their evil army and brought far into the mountains of the north. There she senses the power of the legendary sword and goes on the run with a ragtag group of allies from every race. Here we've got that bit. The film builds a climactic battle where Nain's evil army faces off against the combined forces of the now united races. Eren uses her power as a bear to push the creatures of darkness, revealed as mere stooges for their master with no wills of their own, back into the realm from whence they came. A fraught peace is finally established. Great. Wonderful. Amazing. I might notice... Oh, we actually have these as mission items. That's interesting. I might pay attention to that at some point. We're actually here to take those pictures. So if you don't mind.
The outposts have ammo of all kinds and more besides.
No? Am I running low? On anything? What? No, I'm not running low on anything. Weird bark. Some snaps, some snippy snaps. That's definitely the best angle, isn't it? Is there any good pictures to take of the mountain behind us? Oh, maybe, yeah. Let's have that one, there we go. And then I might hit the screenshot button sometimes while doing this. It won't work if it says lookout point unlocked on the blimmin' screen though, will it? Never mind. Okay, right. That's where we're going to wrap up for today. This has been The Hunter Calls the World. If you've enjoyed watching, please do consider dropping a follow if you're here with me on Twitch, or leaving a like, and maybe even subscribing if you're watching this later on YouTube. You can find me on at twitch.tv/disfordemise_. Or youtube.com/ there's a horrible link for it that's in the description. You can also find me on Twitter at disfordemise _ this time, which is where I send out a tweet every time I go live, and occasionally for other things too, polls and such like. Other than that, I hope you've enjoyed watching. My name has been Dizzy. I'll be back tomorrow at midday. I'm not going to make any promises to what I will or won't stream. Because we know where that got us today. I hope you've enjoyed this tour of some of the reserves that I don't normally play in, or stream in at least. And I will see you all next time, wherever and whenever that may be. Ta-ra all.